this tutorial, you will take a look at the sharpen filter. The download link for the image used in this tutorial is in the video description. Open your image folder and make a copy of the image you want to sharpen. We do this so we can apply the sharpen effect on the copy, and in this way we still have the original image in case something goes wrong or when the effect is not what we want after all. Now right-click on the thumbnail of the copy, go to Open With and click on GIMP. Usually it's better to sharpen an image at its final resolution, and generally speaking, sharpening should be the final step in image editing. When our image is open, we can, if needed, go to View, Zoom and click Fit Image in the window. Click on the Duplicate button at the bottom of the Layers panel to make a duplicate. We do this so we can compare the original and the sharpened image after we have applied the effect. Double-click on the name of the bottom layer and rename it Original. Hit Enter. Then double-click on the name of the top layer and rename this one Sharpened. And again, hit Enter. Go to Filters, Enhance and Sharpen. GIMP has renamed this filter from Unsharp Mask to Sharpen. At the presets, we can use a previous used setting. We can also add the current setting to the preset list, or we can manage the presets. Click Reset to go back to the default settings. With the radius slider, we can set how many pixels on either side of an edge will be affected. High resolution images allow a higher radius. For this image, we make the value 4. With the amount slider, we can set the strength of the sharpening. We should be careful not to overdo this. With most images, subtle sharpening will suffice, unless of course we want to create a particular effect. Here we make the amount 0,6. The threshold slider allows us to set the minimum difference in pixel values that indicates an edge where sharpening must be applied. So you can protect areas of smooth tonal transition from sharpening and avoid creating blemishes in face, sky or water surface. For now, we leave it as it is. We can zoom in and or out by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. This can be done while the dialog box is open. Click the preview off and on to see the difference. Or we enable the split view, which divides the image in before and after. We can click and drag the split line. When we hold the Shift key and click on the line, we can swap the filtered and not filtered area. And when we hold the Control key and click on the line, we can change from vertical to horizontal and back. When the effect is to our liking, we click OK. Now we click the eye of the top layer off and on to see before and after. And there we have our sharpened image. I hope this helps a bit. If that's the case, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching.